The Samsung Galaxy S8. My durability tests have become a rite of passage of sorts for every new smartphone that comes out. And this brand new flagship from Samsung is no different. I'll put it through a few years worth of abuse in just a few minutes. I'll make sure the phone can survive the test of time and see if the S8 is a worthwhile investment for those concerned with durability. Let's get started. This orchid gray color is the one lucky enough to end up on my desk. A new color variation for this round of smartphones, it's nice to see something different than the standard black, gold, and silver that pretty much every manufacturer has. The phone is cold and solid feeling in my hand, so we're off to a good start. The scratch test is always first. My Mohs picks do a pretty good job of seeing how scratch resistant the screen is. Plastic screens like the Galaxy S7 Active would scratch at a level 3. Last year's Galaxy S7 Edge scratched at a level 6, which is pretty much the standard for smartphones at the moment. A sapphire screen would get into the levels 8 or 9 on the hardness scale, and I'm working on getting my hands on one of those phones, but they're pretty rare. The good news is, the Gorilla Glass 5 on this Galaxy S8 scratched at a level 6, so your normal keys and coins won't do any damage to this glass. There is no physical home button on the bottom of the screen. Aesthetically, it looks pretty sweet. I'm a fan of the larger screen size taking up the whole front face. Looking at the earpiece is where I run into my first issue. Definitely a minor issue, but still something to think about. The speaker grille is recessed slightly below the glass surface, which is a very interesting design choice. If it was protruding like on the Galaxy S7, it would help protect the screen a little by not allowing the glass to rest directly on a surface if set face down. Or maybe if it was flush like the LG G6, at least it would look cool and uniform with the rest of the screen. But recessed under the glass is just asking for it to collect all kinds of lint and dust and other goodies from your pocket, or even makeup off your face. Recessed isn't the most ideal design choice. The good news is that the grille is made of metal, so when it does need to be cleaned out, it's pretty secure and won't be falling out on its own, like we've seen with some of the other phones I've tested. One more thing is the speaker's size. The S7 Edge that I've been using for the past year is already pretty quiet, and the grille on the S8 is less than half of the size. So if they shrank the internal speaker inside of the S8, it would be a terrible move. I'll have to check that speaker size when I open up and tear down the phone tomorrow. The sensors, like the iris scanner and the 8-megapixel front-facing camera, are all covered by the same glasses on the screen, so my razor blade is not leaving any marks, since the screen is harder than my razor blade. Now for the back of the phone. The back panel is made of glass, and the Samsung logo is printed on the underside of the glass, so there's no chance of removing it from this side. If we jump up to the flash and the focus sensors, they are also covered by this same glass rear panel. This is the first time I've ever seen a glass-covered flash on a phone. Normally it's plastic. I think that see-through window to the sensor is pretty awesome. If there was a totally clear version of the S8, I would buy it up in 2 seconds. My favorite Game Boy was the clear one back in the day, and older me hasn't changed a bit. Would you buy a clear phone? Let me know in the comments. The camera lens is also covered with glass, and luckily my razor blade leaves no marks on it. Definitely scratch resistant. The Galaxy S8 has a subtle ring around the camera that protrudes ever so slightly. It's almost flush, but the ring is definitely there. It's made of metal, and hopefully if you're the type of person who walks around without a skin or a case, it'll be enough to help protect that camera lens if you ever set your phone down. Now the fingerprint scanner, off to the right of the camera, is definitely in a unique spot. It'll take some getting used to. After heavily scratching the fingerprint scanner, I was able to set my fingerprint with no major issues. It still unlocked the phone almost every time. Without looking though, it was pretty hard to differentiate between the camera lens and the fingerprint scanner with my fingertip, since they are pretty close together. Hopefully muscle memory will improve with time, and I'll get better at it. Now it's time for the hypothetical apocalypse test. The Galaxy S8 has a 5.8-inch Super AMOLED display. Now, in the past, when I roast an AMOLED display with my lighter, like with the Galaxy S7, it'll start to go white after about 10 seconds and never recover. But this Galaxy S8 lasted 30 seconds. The screen still went white, but then completely recovered. I'm happy about the success, but I'm also all about second chances. But even after another 30-second round of flame, the screen had no markings. Definitely impressive. Speaking of apocalyptic scenarios, I talked Audible into giving a free book to every single one of my subscribers. So if dystopian novels are your thing and you like free stuff, I highly recommend Fahrenheit 451 by Ray Bradbury, or another book called 1984 by George Orwell. Both of these books reshaped my entire way of thinking, and well, thought-provoking books are the best kind of books. If you use this link, audible.com/jerryrig, all lowercase, you get to keep the free book you download even if you decide not to use Audible after your free 30-day trial. It's a pretty good deal. I'll also include the link right below this video in the description. A burn-proof phone would be incredible, but in order to make sure, I tried the flame test one last time. It was only then, on my third burn, that I was able to get a permanent mark on the screen. I would definitely certify this thing for a mild to moderate apocalypse, but with any extinction-level events, you're going to need a little more protection. Now, the sides of this phone are made from pure metal. Everything from the SIM card tray to the actual borders of the phone. The phone might look a little beat up at this point, but it's still less violent than Flying United. All of the buttons are made from metal. Even Bixby, our permanent new best friend that nobody asked for, is also metal. Down at the bottom of the phone, we have the USB-C port, which I prefer at this point. The transition to USB-C is pretty much mandatory on all flagships this far into the game. There's also a headphone jack down here. You can charge your phone and listen to music at the same time. How ridiculous would it be if your phone couldn't do something basic like that? Another interesting thing about the Galaxy S8 is that the rear panel is structural. It's embedded inside the metal frame, instead of resting on top. I managed to permanently borrow the rear back panel off of what's inside Galaxy S8 that we cut open a few days ago. It looks like the glass coloring can be scraped off from underneath the glass, leaving a cloudy clear surface behind the logo. I think it looks pretty cool. That clear galaxy should definitely be a thing. It took several hard hits with my knife to destroy the back panel, and when it finally did crack, it spiderwebbed similar to the LG G6, where everything was still relatively intact, much safer than the HTC U Ultra, where the large unlaminated glass chunks were falling off all over the place. And now it's time for the ultimate test of build quality, the bin test. 2 years ago, the Galaxy S6 was the first phone I ever did a durability test on, and Samsung has never disappointed since when it comes to building physically solid devices. There is almost zero flex to this thing, and more importantly, no seals are being broken either, so everything is still water resistant. It's nice that you can count on your phone, even if an irresponsibly large amount of pressure is applied to both ends. The flashlight complained for a few seconds about the abuse, but other than that, I'd have to say that the Galaxy S8 is an incredibly well-built phone, and definitely a candidate for my daily driver. My Twitter and Instagram followers got a spoiler-free preview of the phone before this video went live, so if you like seeing tech tested, follow me over there. And don't forget your free 30-day trial from Audible. For real. It's free. With Audible, you can read or listen directly from your phone, so you'll always have something productive in your pocket. Link is in the description. I'll see you guys tomorrow for the teardown. Thanks for watching. I'll see you around.